Hi, it's time for another verb of the day. Today's verb is charge. Let's take a look at some of the ways this verb is used. The first way you might hear the verb charge used is to mean to set or ask a fee or for a payment of some kind. So you might hear of a business charging a certain fee or certain amount for a particular product or service. A second way you're likely going to hear people use the verb charge is to refer to giving an electric charge to something, so supplying the battery of something with energy. So how you'll likely hear this usage is, I need to charge my phone, or my computer needs to be charged. A third way to use the verb charge is to mean to run towards in order to attack. Sometimes you'll see this in history books to describe a particular battle, one side charged the other. You might also sometimes hear fans at a sporting event yell, charge, kind of a way to encourage their team to attack, or and not in a violent way, but in a way to score a point that might lead them to victory. You should know that charge is a regular verb. To use to make the progressive tense, you first need to drop the E and then add ing to form charging. The past tense and participle forms of this verb are made by adding just the letter D, since this verb already ends in an E. The base verb, charge, ja, is making a voiced sound. So our past tense ending is going to make a D sound. Charged, charged. Notice I'm not adding an extra syllable, an id, to this. It's just a D sound. Now let's spend some time talking about phrasal verbs. And from the note on the right side of my screen, you can see that we're going to be discussing a number of phrasal verbs with charge. And you'll see that some of these tie back to the earlier meanings we looked at, and some of the others will have completely different meanings. So let's start with the phrasal verb charge against. This means to pay for something from a specific account or a particular category. Sometimes you'll hear nonprofits talking about charging something against a particular funding source. And you'll see an example here in the example sentence. The company charges fees against employees' 401k accounts. So a fee is being removed from these particular accounts. Another phrasal verb you might hear is charge at. Again, this ties back to that third definition we looked at a few minutes ago, to aggressively rush toward someone or something. An example of that could be, the elephant charged at the hunters. So it ran towards them in an aggressive way, like it was going to attack. Another phrasal verb you might hear is charge for. This means to set a price for something. So again, tying back to that first definition we looked at. Here's an example of this phrasal verb in a question. How much do you charge for an hour of babysitting? Right? So what is your price? The next phrasal verb we'll look at is charge into. It means to move quickly or run wildly into a particular place or location. An example of that could be, the firefighter has charged into numerous burning buildings. So this idea of charge into, usually I think of it as done without a lot of planning or a lot of forethought. It's an emergency, or there's something that makes you make this quick decision and move quickly or run wildly. Now, before we move to our second set of phrasal verbs, I want to take just a moment here to look at some of the verb tenses I used in my example sentences. We're not going to do any separate verb tense practice today because we have so many phrasal verbs, but if you look at our first sentence, the company charges fees against, you're gonna see this is an example of the simple factual statement. In the second example, the elephant charged at. That's an example of simple past tense. Now, there aren't any time signals indicating a known time period in this particular sentence, but we could imagine it being part of a known time in the course of someone's story, telling what happened last month or on the last hunting trip. The third example sentence or question is also simple present. How much do you charge for? Again, a factual statement. And the fourth example sentence, has charged into, is an example of the present perfect. So we know this event has occurred in the past. We don't know when. And this is probably an action that's going to continue as long as this person continues to work as a firefighter. Now, let's continue looking at some phrasal verbs with charge. There are three more phrasal verbs on this page, but each of them are going to have two meanings. So the first one we'll look at is charge on. This can mean to put the cost of something on a credit card or some sort of credit account. An example of that could be, what card should we charge it on? Perhaps the person working at cash register might ask this question as they wait for you to find a particular credit card. A second way to use charge on is to mean to demand the payment of interest or a penalty. Let me give you an example of this. The company will charge a late fee on all payments received after the 15th. So here, this is demanding a penalty for late payment. The next phrasal verb we'll look at is charge up. Again, this can have two different meanings. One could be to become excited or agitated. An example of that might be, this band is going to charge up the crowd before the big game. Here, this would tie to kind of the excited meaning. This has a more positive meaning, hopefully getting the fans really excited prior to the big game. A second way to use charge up ties back to our second definition of the main verb, so putting electricity in a battery. Now, you don't always have to use up after charge here. So my example sentence, the battery will charge up in under an hour, means it will fully charge or up to its capacity. I could also just say the battery will charge in under an hour. And those two sentences would generally be understood and have about the same meaning. The last phrasal verb we'll look at today is charge with. This can also have at least two meanings, one being to formally accuse someone of a crime. Here's an example of this meaning. They were arrested yesterday and charged with theft. They were charged with stealing. A second way to use charge with is to mean to assign a particular task to a person. Here's an example of that. My boss charged me with updating the company handbook. So it is my responsibility, or it's my task, to make updates to this document. Now, before we look at some related words, let's take a moment to look at the verb tenses that have been used in our example sentences. The first, the question here, what card should we charge it on, is a modal. It's asking for advice, or in this case, maybe a recommendation, which card. The second sentence, will charge a late fee, is an example of the simple future, as is the second one, is going to charge up. The other will charge up, also simple future. The first example with charged with, they were arrested yesterday and charged with that, is an example of the passive voice in the past tense. In the last example, my boss charged me with updating. This is an example of simple past in the active voice. Now we're ready to take a look at some words and phrases that are related to our verb charge. And the first word we're going to look at is just the noun form of this word. The spelling is the same, as is the pronunciation. And just like our verb, this noun can have a number of different meanings. We're just going to look at four of them. So the first way you might hear the noun charge used is to mean a price asked for goods or services. Here's an example sentence. What's the charge for all these items? You might hear someone else just use price in its place there. What's the price for all of these items? That would have the same meaning. A second way the noun charge is used is to mean a formal accusation. Here's an example of that. They will appear in court on a charge of embezzlement. Embezzlement is generally stealing money from a company with which you work because you have access to the cash or money or supplies or something. A fourth way to use the noun charge is to mean the responsibility of taking care or control of someone or something. An example of that, she will be in my charge all afternoon. So I might be watching my friend's child, as an example. So that child is going to be my responsibility for that particular afternoon. A fourth way to use the noun charge is to refer to a thrill. So something that's fun and exciting. Here's an example. Roller coasters give me a real charge. Now we're going to end our lesson here with two phrases that I think are pretty common to hear. One is in charge. So this means one is in control or has overall responsibility. An example of that could be the substitute teacher is in charge of class today. So substitute teacher, hopefully, is in control or is responsible for students' learning. A second phrase you might hear is free of charge. So this means that no payment is due. Similarly, you might hear someone say they're no charge for a particular service. Let's look at our example sentence here. If you buy your tires here, we'll rotate them in the future free of charge. So sometimes businesses will offer certain services or extras in hopes that you will purchase goods from them. Thanks so much for watching today's video. I hope you have